All right, so check this out. I got this email, right? Tell me if you wouldn't have totally freaked out. Jake, I'm investigating allegations of sexual harassment at your workplace, and your name was mentioned. Could we discuss this over a call next week? Signed by Samantha Richardson from Equality Law Group. I mean, I knew that I hadn't done anything wrong. Still, this whole situation shook me to my core. In any case, I replied, sure, and we scheduled a call for the following week. Meanwhile, I just had to find out who this Samantha Richardson really was. So I Googled her. Sure enough, her company's website came up, and there she was. Her picture staring back at me along with a list of court cases she had won. What could I say? I felt compelled to see what kind of cases she usually tackles. So I clicked on one of them and downloaded a Word file, only to find it was corrupted. Little did I know, I had just infected my computer with a keylogger. The whole scenario turned out to be a scam. Samantha, her website, everything was fake. I only connected the dots a week later when she didn't show up to our meeting. And for a whole week, they had been sneakily swiping my passwords and even gained access to my employer's network. Here's the thing. Phishing emails don't always come armed with a suspicious link that you've been warned to avoid. Oh no, these guys know exactly what buttons to push. They knew I wouldn't be able to resist doing a little online detective work. And here's the sobering truth. I was probably just one of many they targeted. Just another fish in the sea. You know?